On these charts are shown some of the most vulnerable areas of the human body. Areas in which a well-directed blow will render an opponent temporarily helpless. The baton is a weapon designed to attack, scientifically, the impact points of the human body shown on these charts. The baton should be directed against the side of the neck, the clavicle or collarbone, the shoulder tip, the outer biceps, the inner elbow, the ribs, the solar plexus, the forearm, the hand, the groin, the thigh, the kneecap, the calf, the instep, the toes, and the shin, against the scapula or shoulder blade, the kidney, the elbow tip or crazy bone, the knee, the calf, the ankle bone, and the tendon above the heel. A well-delivered blow to any of the points shown on these charts is usually sufficient to disable, temporarily, the average man. Sometimes, against extremely large and powerful individuals, two or more blows may be required to definitely render an opponent helpless. Let us see now just how a baton is used to attack the impact points shown on these charts. Here we see chops to the neck, to the collarbone, to the shoulder tip, to the outer biceps, to the inner elbow, a jab to the ribs, a jab to the groin, chops to the thigh, to the kneecap, to the calf, to the instep, to the toes, and to the shin. What happened, Sergeant? Well, let's look at some of these combination techniques, shall we? Here we see a chop to the calf, a jab to the stomach, and a chop to the chest. Now a jab to the stomach, a butt stroke to the ribs, and a jab to the ribs. And here a chop to the arm, a butt stroke to the ribs, and a chop to the calf. Looks pretty convincing, doesn't it? In addition to the basic baton techniques which we have seen demonstrated so far, there are other techniques which law enforcement officers find extremely useful. One of these is the drunk come-along. Notice that the baton hand is held palm up to prevent losing the baton. Here we have the one-arm come-along, which provides easy control over the movements of a suspect. This one is the one-arm takedown. Here it is again, this time in slow motion. A very useful technique when dealing with a belligerent suspect. Now we see the baton hammerlock. Again, the baton hammerlock in slow motion. This technique is especially useful for handling an intoxicated person or for removing an agitator from a mob. Notice that the officer's right hand and left arm are both tight against his opponent's neck to keep the suspect from turning. Note, too, that the officer ends up by taking a step back, pulling his opponent off balance. This prevents a suspect from throwing the officer over his head. No matter how careful an officer may be, at some time he will find that a suspect has been able to grab his baton. When that happens, the officer must be able to release it quickly and surely. One technique for doing this is the baton jerk release, seen here. Let's watch that again, this time in slow motion. The follow-up jab discourages the suspect from grabbing the baton again. Another technique for releasing a baton is the jab release, seen now. The slow motion camera shows how the officer raises the tip end of the baton, then forces it down between his opponent's arms. As before, a follow-up attack discourages further grabbing. A third technique for releasing a baton from an opponent's grasp is the wrist release. See how the officer combines quick movement with leverage to free his baton, and then follows through with a sharp attack. Here is another release technique, the baton stomach throw. If, because of the suspect's superior size and strength, other release techniques prove ineffective, the baton stomach throw will force the suspect to release his grip on the baton. The baton is an excellent defensive weapon against kicks and blows. Here an officer parries a kick to the groin. Notice how the officer bends forward from the waist, arms straight, elbows locked, keeping the baton slightly below the groin. Here, the officer blocks a crushing overhead blow aimed at his head. The baton is held parallel to the ground. The officer's arms are straight, his elbows locked, his weight evenly distributed on both feet. Now we see a series of one-arm baton parries, demonstrating how a blow from any direction can be effectively blocked. Watch now, as the officer and his assistant go at this in dead earnest. A baton against a knife? Easy. Watch this. When parrying an overhead knife attack, the officer blocks the suspect's arm, not the knife. Then he follows through with a baton attack. If the knife attack comes at waist level instead of from overhead, the baton is just as effective. As before, the officer parries the arm of the suspect, then follows through with a baton attack. Well, now that we know something about the baton, let's look back at the deputy who had to defend himself against the two juvenile lawbreakers. The deputy saw trouble coming and raised his baton to the port arms position. The two youths spread out, then both jumped him at the same time. One went for the deputy's gun, while the other grabbed onto his baton and tried to wrestle it from his grasp. The deputy, by proper use of his baton, successfully handled a civil disturbance which involved defending himself and the doctor against two large juvenile lawbreakers. When an officer becomes involved in a physical disturbance, the few simple rules and techniques we have learned here for the baton will, after much practice, enable him to survive an attack, to counterattack, and to gain the advantage without endangering his own life or seriously injuring his opponents. Remember these facts about the baton. One, it is not a club. It is a weapon designed to deliver blows scientifically to the most vulnerable parts of the human body. Two, proper use of the baton requires knowledge, courage, strength, good footwork, and practice. Three, the baton, when carried in a military manner, is a symbol of law and order. It usually acts as a deterrent to violence. Four, if trouble does come, the baton is a valuable law enforcement tool for close-in fighting, as well as for handling an opponent at normal combat distance. The police officer who knows how to use his baton with propriety can perform his duties with an extra measure of confidence, secure in the knowledge that he has an advantage over every lawbreaker, not only in pressing an attack, but in effective defense and counterattack as well.